RockTheDJ.com. Stupid.
Yo, hey, what's happening, man? Welcome back, Shawty. Y'all didn't tell that what up. You know what I'm saying? Welcome back. I know y'all didn't think I was going to be back. Y'all been texting me. Y'all been calling me. Y'all been tweeting me. It been a whole lot of complaints. Mac, where you at? I really didn't think y'all like listening to me so much. But since y'all do, I got to shout out the people who always texting me and asking me when I'm finna drop another podcast or when I'm finna do something. So shout out to Can't Trust Them. You know what I'm saying? Always getting on my nerves and asking me when I'm finna record something. Shout out to my homie at the Nerd Bay. Whenever I say something, when we gonna pod again? Well, here we podding. Nah, we just chilling, man. So anywho, man, I just came to speak to y'all a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Go over some videos, some things that I seen in the media, in the urban black space. Hell yeah. So anyways, y'all might not know this, but I am a part of one of the Black Greek Letter organizations, a member of the Defy Nine. Shout out to me. Fall 2008 at the University of Central Florida. You feel me? So going viral, I seen a few other members of the Defy Nine, and I kind of felt like, you know, it was worthy to talk about it. So if y'all allow me to talk about it, I would talk about it. I call this video Greeks Gone Wild. Cause the shit get a little wild. It get a little wild. Let's start off with the first joint. Oh, let me start off. First of all, this group of young distinguished individuals. This is Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. Hold on. Do that shit. Do that. I want to post the custody. Hey, run it back one more time. They had the hoes until they said the thing too. Oh, I know them niggas. Oh no, he didn't say that. Yes, he did, girl. I'm like, I don't have no kids, girls. I don't want your number. You can get it how you live, girl. That's on the rear, girl. Shout out to Lil Wayne. But hell yeah, those was the young men's Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Corporate. You know, back in my day, the Alphas used to kind of consider themselves as the most intelligent of all the five fraternities. They were allegedly the first. And you know, they kind of hold themselves to a higher, I guess, higher level, whatnot. They wear bow ties and whatnot, you know, and regular ties and suits all the time. And they supposed to have like really high GPAs and be really intelligent young men. And I'm gonna be honest, I ain't never seen no Alpha sitting there like that. I'm old though. We barely had cell phones when I was in college. So I'm old though, don't listen to me. So I will say this, when it comes to young men doing things of that nature, they're young. A lot of testosterone, you know, if they're in college, some of them had just started having sexual intercourse. That's a big deal. You know, they don't really know how to express themselves. And I'm spitting because I just ate some for Trader Joe's. They don't really know how to express themselves as they should. I ain't never seen that before. So, you know, the biggest thing I can take from that is, young men, you got to learn decorum. I don't even know if that's the correct political word, but you got to learn decorum. There's a time and a place for everything. When I was coming up, those type of chants were relegated to like house parties and clubs and stuff for the night where nobody can't see us. Mind you, we didn't have cameras in our cell phones, so I can't really, you know, say I ain't never did it before, but you ain't supposed to be in the middle of the day on campus. Hey, listen, we've all felt, you know what, hindsight is 2020. I'm speaking, I can't say I ain't never did none of that. All I'm saying is, listen, as an older gentleman, looking back at you, I'm just saying, hey, practice decorum, time and the place, represent your organization as you should. And, you know, when you in the place where that is allowed and that is, you know, okay, and may not be recorded, then go for it. All right, let's move on. So we're gonna shift from Alpha Phi Alpha, which is 1906, to the young ladies, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. Y'all come take a walk with me. Take a walk.
A.K.A. probate at Tennessee State University.
That's crazy. Running back.
A.K.A. probate at Tennessee State University.
Yeah. A lot of AKs. Okay. So apparently, that was the Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated down at up at Tennessee State University. Shout out to Tennessee State. You know, I come from Cassidy High School. We had a few players go to Tennessee State. So there's a special place in my heart for Tennessee State University. And I would love to visit there one day. So it was 175 new initiates of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. And that went viral. Because that is a lot of people. Let's start off by saying congratulations. Congratulations. That is a lot of people. But I think a part of the Greek experience was coming in, meeting some people, and then having a certain bonding experience that led you to kind of grow together in life, right? You know what I'm saying? And it's hard to grow together with somebody in life when there's 175 of y'all. That is a lot of people. I think at some point you can't call this a line. 175 is a graduation class. Like, y'all do realize there's people who graduated high school without 175 people in their graduating class. That's a pledge class. That's not a line. So for me, I guess the only even negative, I guess, quote I would say is at some point it looked like it may not be always about brotherhood or sisterhood, and it might be more about the dollars. Like, I figure, you know, if you pledge all these girls or whatever, you bring them all in at two stacks. Let's do two stacks. 175 times two stacks. How much is that? I'm guessing. I don't know how much it costs to be a K. I'm guessing. 350 racks. I'm spending a lot. Hey, I had some lemonade from Trader Joe's. That thing got, I need to drink some water. That 350 racks, to me, it is like, dog, it may not be about sisterhood. It may not be about brotherhood as much as some people thought when you start seeing these lines of 100, 200. To me, it might be a way to fund the organization. But that, hey, listen, let's be clear. That's none of my business. That is none of my business. Congratulations again. none of my business. I'm just observing. Congratulations. Okay, man, let's go on to our third video on the night. This is like America's funniest videos. America's Greece Gone Wild videos. This last video is displaying a new initiate of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Y'all give me a second, because this one on Twitter, but we're going to look at the footage. Hold on. How I get to the footage? Let's look at the footage. What's going on here?
Piece on bling blow, neck piece on blizzard, baby. I throw some ones, baby, you do that dance on me, baby. I throw 1,000 more, keep shaking that ass on me, baby. Young nigga round with him. Yeah.
Okay, he came.
Yeah, young nigga round 50,000 cash on me. Yeah. Hopping out a black truck, off white fit. Nigga, it took a lot of grinding just to talk this shit. Nigga, real awesome. I gotta get off of these bitches. Nigga, pockets full of.
Oh, y'all ain't wanna
I'm starting to walk like a chick.
Oh, we running around.
Dance on me, baby. Young nigga round with him. Yeah,
hit that thing.
Young nigga round 50,000 cash on me. Hopping out a black truck, off white fit. Nigga, it took a lot of grinding just to talk this shit. Nigga,
that's crazy. Now, I'm gonna be honest with y'all, right? I'm gonna tell my truth. I'm not gonna act like, not me personally, but I'm not gonna act like we have never simulated an orgasm on stage. When I say we, I mean me and my little group in our undergraduate stage. I ain't gonna act like we ain't never simulated orgasm. I ain't gonna lie. But that might have been the furthest I've ever seen somebody go doing some shit like that. I wasn't even post custody. I ain't gonna lie. Listen, if you might pull that off in my organization, they might come and get your letters. You might wake up the next day and no longer be a member of said organization. You know, so it goes back to the thing I said about the office, man. Hey, decorum, time and place. I get it. We nasty. Oh, I get it. We yang and woo-de-woo. But at some point, hey, this is too far. It's kids in the crowd. It's kids in the crowd, dog. You see, it's distinguished people in the crowd. You know what I'm saying? I get it. You young or whatever. But like, some of this stuff stick with you for the rest of your life. And some of it ain't really worth it. Like, what do you benefit from busting a nut on stage? I really don't. That gonna get you my hoes? What happens? I don't know. But hey, congratulations to all those new members. Congratulations to everybody. I hope you know you guys enjoyed it. And mind you, I'm saying, like, this is coming from somebody who I've kind of done a lot of this. Not to the extent in which they did it, but I kind of did the same, so I understand. You young, you know what I'm saying? You energetic, testosterone. You wanna, you know what I'm saying? You trying to show out, for sure. But, you know, as an older person, if I could go back and change and do some of those things different, I would have. So I can't blame you for doing what you're doing because I have done similar, right? But as an older person, I can say, try not to do it too much. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, hey, how about this? The one thing we should have did that we should have just ran it by somebody. Did y'all run that by somebody? Just, hey, pro fight, what you think? Just run it by somebody. Easy as that. All right, man, let's move on to the 48 Laws of Power. Y'all know what the 48 Laws of Power gotta say. This is a great book. It's by Robert Greene. It is not the Bible, but it's the second closest thing to it. So listen, 48 Laws of Power. To this particular situation, everybody is set for the Cavs. The Cavs ain't really do nothing, so it don't really matter. Oh, you know what I'm saying? Congratulations. So, in the 48 laws, y'all be making me read out loud. Don't be laughing at me and shit. For this situation, we're going to look at law number 34. Law number 34 says, be royal in your own fashion. Act like a king, be treated like one. Law number 34, be royal in your own fashion. Act like a king to be treated like one. Law number 34, be royal in your own fashion. Act like a king to be treated like one. In summation, people would treat you how you present yourself. If you present yourself like an asshole, people gonna treat you like an asshole. If you present yourself as a broke boy, people gonna treat you as a broke boy. But if you present yourself like a king, then you shall be treated like a king. So be very wary on how you present yourself. That's simple. All right, man. Hey, listen, I'm gonna come back. I'm gonna check it back in with y'all. All the grease y'all keep not doing. Y'all take, listen, don't do what we did. Be better than us. Congratulations. I'm going to see y'all next time. Am I going to see y'all next time?